today under Ramon Dominguez, who led the U.S. in total wins last year. Number four, Birdstone, in the colors of the Mary Lou Whitney Stables. Mary Lou and Nick Zito won a race on the card already today. In fact, Zito has two winners already today. In the Derby, Birdstone lost one of his shoes, finished eighth, but he did win the Champagne Stakes as a two-year-old on this Belmont track last year. And him up closer to the pace today. And there's Smarty Jones, Pennsylvania bred, but conceived in Kentucky. And all the Kentucky breeders trying to get him to stand at stud at their farm now. Last week, an offer of $30 million for him, $40 million if he wins the Belmont. We understand just a day ago, the offer now has gone to $50 million if he wins the Belmont Stakes today. Marty Jones, sift different tracks, his ninth different distance. He is 8 for 8. And now,
wake up in a city that never sleeps and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hills, a number one. These little times.
Tap dancer, then Eddington, and then Smarty Jones. There's Lauren Venosa, Stuart Elliott's fiance. And now for the call of the 136 Belmont Stakes. Here's Tom Durkin.
Smarty Jones takes his spot in post nine, moments away from the start. Will he take his place in racing history? We'll see. They're off in the 136 Belmont. Smarty Jones got off to a good beginning today. Eddington not off particularly well. Rock Hard 10 is showing speed this afternoon. He's right up there with Smarty Jones, who's on the outside. Purge comes through on the rail, and Eddington will be on the outside of Smarty Jones as they move into the clubhouse turn. And then it's Cayman now, who's running fifth and angles over toward the inside. Birdstone in between horses sixth, Royal Assault to seventh. Master David is reined in to run back in eighth position, and long shot Tap Dancer trails the field. Purge is the leader. Rock Hard 10 right up on the pace today, and Stuart Elliott trying to find a comfort zone there with Smarty Jones. They're in the clear on the outside third, not far behind Jerry Bailey and Eddington running along in fourth. Then they're followed by Royal Assault and Birdstone on the outside. The opening quarter went in 24 1/5 seconds. The half, 48 3/5 seconds. The pace is fairly soft, and Smarty Jones has taken the lead as they begin their long journey down the Belmont backstretch. But he's not going to get a breather. It is Eddington to press him all the way, and Rock Hard 10 looms large just in behind the lead. He's only 2 lengths behind Smarty Jones now. There's a break of another 2.5 lengths back, and Purge down toward the inside. He's working harder to be fourth. Birdstone's alongside him. The field now moving for the 5 furlong marker. Smarty Jones, a challenge on the inside from Rock Hard 10. There's 5 furlongs to go, just a minute from the wire, and Smarty Jones has to hold on to that lead for just 1 minute more. Rock Hard 10 is pressing him from the inside. Eddington is working harder to stay within 2 lengths of the lead. Birdstone commences a rally. He's 6 lengths from the front. Purge has nothing left. Then farther back, it's Royal Assault, Master David, and Tap Dancer around the far turn, and it's Smarty Jones. He lets it out a notch to lead by a length and a half. Birdstone is coming up on the outside. Rock Hard 10 is toiling. He's now 3 lengths behind. They're coming to the top of the stretch. Smarty Jones is a 4-length lead. Birdstone is moving to be second on the outside. Rock Hard 10 is back to third. And Smarty Jones enters the stretch to the roar of 120,000. But Birdstone is going to make him earn it today. The whip is out on Smarty Jones. It's been 26 years. It's just 1 furlong away. Birdstone is an upside front. They're coming down to the finish. Can Smarty Jones hold on? Here comes Birdstone. Birdstone surges past. Birdstone wins the Belmont Stakes. Smarty Jones was valiant but vanquished, finishing second. Royal Assault came on to be third. And so this triple crown
remains vacated for 26 long years, and this magical Triple Crown trail of Smarty Jones comes to a disheartening end in the final strides of the Belmont Stakes.
Hearts broken again in the final strides at the Belmont. They ganged up on him, everybody took a shot at him, and Birdstone finally got there in the closing strides. Remember Birdstone, one of the few horses that had raced over this Belmont Oval. He won the Champagne Stakes, the biggest race for two-year-olds here in New York last year. He had sort of fallen on hard times this spring. In the Kentucky Derby, he lost a shoe, didn't run well, but he came back to the track where he'd had his greatest success and upset Smarty's bid for the Triple Crown, the first loss in Smarty Jones' career. It's the first Belmont victory for Nick Zito, the New Yorker, in 12 tries after finishing second five times. And Donna is with Stuart Elliott on Smart
Cheer. As a two-year-old, and now he's going to engage you in mid-stretch. Tell us about it.
Yeah, well, I seen him coming pretty strong, and my horse was trying. We just couldn't hold him off.
The early jousting with the other horses on both sides of you, Purge, Rock Hard 10, Eddington, ultimately perhaps cost you this race?
I would say more so just the mile and a half.
Mile and a half, and there's the winner, Birdstone. Stuart, congratulations on one great ride in this Triple Crown.
Thank you.
A gracious Stuart Elliott.
We're ready for the start of the 135th Traverse Stakes. They are in the gate, and they are off. And Lionheart was off just a beat slowly, but quickly he's making strides, and he's racing eagerly for the lead. Eddington has reined in to run back in second, and Purge is going to move right with Lionheart as they move by us for the first time. Here's Suave to be third. Sir Shackleton is running along in fourth. And then it's Eddington, followed by Birdstone, and stretch running the cliff's edge is the trailer as the field hits the clubhouse turn. Lionheart and Purge is pushing him along. Eddington just in behind the lead, sitting third, through a quarter that goes in 24 and 2/5 seconds. So Lionheart out there with the lead. Joe Bravo trying to settle him down while in front. Purge is back off a bit. Purge is backed off a length and a half behind the leader in second position. On the inside, Eddington in hand in third. And that's Suave in the clear in fourth. Birdstone down on the inside in fifth position. And alongside him, it's Sir Shackleton. And Shane Sellers guides the cliff's edge for clear running to the outside down the backstretch run. 48 seconds flat for the opening half mile. So that does augur well for Lionheart, who gets away with a fairly easy opening half mile. The leader by a length. On the outside, Purge right there, poised to Ponston second. And Birdstone. Birdstone is now third as they move for the far turn. He's only a length and a half behind now. Around the far turn. And it is Purge to the throat latch of Lionheart. Those two head to head. Here comes the Belmont winner, Birdstone. He's sweeping toward the lead on the outside. He's now third. Eddington is fourth. And the cliff's edge is powering up on the outside. As the field turns for home, Lionheart has come up empty. Birdstone up for the lead. Birdstone in front. Purge is battling with him on the outside, the cliff's edge. Eddington is fourth at the rail. Birdstone at the eighth pole with the lead. The cliff's edge takes it to him. Zito 1-2 with the 16th to go. And little Birdstone digs down. The cliff's edge could not get to him in the darkness at Saratoga. Birdstone has won the 135th Belmont Stakes. His stablemate, the cliff's edge, was second. Eddington was third. And Purge was fourth.